Welcome to yet another episode of the Economic Times Cutting Chai Stories, a series of conversations with CXOs and business leaders over chai or coffee, if that's your preference, brought to you by ET Edge, where we talk about their lives, hobbies, interests, and also touch upon various other topics. The urgency and pressure on business leaders as they navigate the COVID-19 pandemic has been immense. And right now, we are in the midst of the second wave. These business leaders have been constantly monitoring myriad ways to ensure that their respective companies stay on course in the new normal. The incredible demands placed on them makes us often wonder how they have time for family, hobbies, or any personal downtime. And let's not forget that they are mere mortals. This initiative by ETH is aimed to create a deeper connection with them and to get a sense of what business leaders of several prominent companies do when they are not in business mode. Today, it's my pleasure to host Ashok Nayak, Chief Information Officer, IPCA Laboratories Limited. Ashok, welcome to the Economic Times Cutting Chai Stories.
Thanks, Ivan. Pleasure to meet you and a pleasure to have a conversation with you.
Likewise. So let's kick off this cutting chai conversation, Ashok, by me asking you, you've spent 30 years with IPCA Laboratories. Is that a fact?
Yes, very true.
Wow. Might not be in the same role, but 30 years with one organization. I mean, in today's day and age, it's unfathomable. In the old days, you know, if it was a bank or a government job or whatever, it was understandable. So in Hindi, you know, what I'd like to ask is lambe innings ka raaz kya hai?
Okay, that's a great question, Ivan, and I love to answer that to everyone whenever I come across, because you are right, like say, in today's world, sticking to one company looks a little odd for everyone. However, how I look at this is, I started my career here in finance, and then I always had inclination towards moving to IT. So I was doing a lot of courses in IT, having my coding courses done, my diplomas done and everything. So fortunately, you know, there is a famous dialogue in a film called Shah Rukh Khan dialogue. I don't recollect film now, but I remember the dialogue, like say, kis cheech ko aap chahte ho use milane ke liye aapko shiddat se chahte ho use milane ke liye aapko kainat mil jati hai
right?
So famous. I'm not sounding like a Shah Rukh Khan, apologies for that. So then I got a chance to work in IT here in a smaller position, but then like say how it like the opportunities came on my way. And I have seen that in a lot of crises, either with the company, because information technology was not a very, when I started my career in this company, so information technology was not having a very prominent
support department that everybody could blame and take credit for their department, a cost center left in the corner.
Very true. So people used to call it as an EDP, electronic process department, but I used to call it as an everyday problem. So apologies for that. I started, and what kept me motivating, like say, as and when the opportunities were created, and I got the opportunities to work in information technology and then deploy a lot of applications around. So slowly. So I never thought of moving out of this company, because it keeps me kept me motivating to achieve what my goal is and where I'm today. So
right.
I'm doing the entire niche, and it's completely like say the thought process of the company has changed, so called. So thanks to the IT industry also have disrupted the entire industry. So now there is no way, like say, or you cannot ignore IT anymore in business.
Absolutely.
People have seen this in the pandemic, like say you were forced, or employees were forced to work from home. So IT came in front and then made them unable to continue their business.
Sure.
So basic is like say it's always motivated me to see like say how so that is why I never thought of moving out of this company.
Wonderful. Another Sachin of the IT industry. Started and debuted at 16 and retired at that with a lot of accolades. Okay, Ashok, over the past 30 years, you have probably seen it all, the good, the bad, and the ugly. Could you take us through some of the highs and lows of your career and share with us what you learned from it?
Perfect. Let's say if I say what I have learned from this and my long innings or in my career, I have learned three Ps. One is a passion, that you need to have a passion to achieve something, and you need to have a goal to. So unless you have a passion, you cannot deliver best. This is what in the whole career I have understood and practiced it. Then you need to be
Okay.
persistent enough. Let's say you need to be continuously on a job. So, what I would say here, let's say every output has to be an input. But you need to understand that every input will not give you an output. So, the day you understand, you are happy in the life. So, persistent, you need to be very persistent in whatever you're doing, you're achieving your passion. And third is a patience. So you need to be very patient with the results. You need to be very so. As I said, like say every input may not yield your results. So
Sure.
you need to be very patient with your whatever efforts you are doing. So this is what the learning what I have learned. And on the lower side, say since you don't have an attack to get into this industry, I came into this industry by making well, let's say. Entry like the when the there was a crisis in the company, I would put it that way. Like, say there was
Okay.
no one, the Y2K was on the other side where systems were to be deployed and implemented, a lot of things were there. So, I used that crisis, and since I had done a lot of work in the coding and developed small applications in the company, so they were knowing me that I'm know about the applications, I know about the domain, and so they provided me chance in that crisis, and I came with the flying colors during those crises, and this is how my journey. But having spent 30 years, it's a roller coaster journey for me. It was not easy. Like so I have seen a lot of ups and downs in this, as you rightly mentioned. So if I talk about my achievement, out of this my passion, I am today heading this and heading the digital journey of this company. So as I mentioned earlier, like say this company was not having a prominence place for IT, but now today IT is in their core functions, like say helping business to run around. It's not a stoppage of my journey. I'm still trying to do, like say I'm working on a project now, like say how the functions are made smart. So it continues. So if I look at, like say what I'm in a position is my achievement today with this company. And in my career, and lowers are like say there are multiple lowers. Like say when you because you don't have a tag, your acceptance and the entry level itself is a question.
Sure.
So you have to overcome all those things by every time showing your achievements or you're showing your value to the company.
True.
But I did enjoy it, so no regrets on my lower.
Yeah, as long as the end results justify the journey, that's fine.
Perfect.
As a follow-up question, how would you describe your leadership style?
Good question, Ivan. Because I often ask this question to myself very often. I have been gone through a lot of managerial trainings. I've done my MBA with the ICFI. Then our company has a very prominent towards teaching the upcoming leaders. So they sent me through IIM Indore and for a 1 year course. So I have learned a lot of about the grids. Like say you might have heard about the styles of the leaders 1-1, 1-9, 9-1, 9-9 and all. So having said that, what I firmly believe is there is no a particular style that one can follow, and I try to be very close to 9-9 grid, and that is not achievable. By the way, it's someone's wish to achieve to a 9-9, but in practical world it is not possible. If you talk about my particular style, I follow everything based on the environment and the situation I'm in. Because sometimes you need to be 1-9, sometimes you need to be 9-1, sometimes you need to be 5-5. So I don't have any particular style, but I try to be very close to 9-9. And secondly, I don't believe, like, say leaders can be selected or elected. So there are different ways to become a leader, but the one who are followed or the one who have the impression on the masses or the people are the one who thinks something differently from the normal people is what I believe. And I continue to do that. If you talk about my team members, I always nurture them not to be clone of everything, anything rather, not to be clone of any particular behavior or a pattern or anything. You do it your own. Like, say, if you clone someone, you are tend to execute, not innovate. So this is what my, I always give a nurturing to my team members. And it, they come out with a lot of innovative solutions for a company. So this is fantastic. What I believe in my leadership.
Fantastic. Okay. Ashok, our generation has witnessed the VUCA world. And for those of us who are not familiar with the term, it's volatility, uncertainty, complexity, and ambiguity. That's what VUCA is an acronym for. And with the COVID-19 pandemic being a prime example of that, we've had the first wave, the second wave, and the third wave is probably lurking around the corner. What kind of learnings can be taken forward from this crisis, Ashok? And if you could even, I know the time is short, but if you could even touch on the positives of this crisis in terms of learnings.
Sure. See, there is nothing new to the everyone now. We are into the second stage of this pandemic. And everyone, I hope, has learned a lot of lessons, whether it is an individual, whether it is society, business, or government. You take any one, I think everyone has learned a lot of, because this was the very scariest pandemic which our generation has seen. Now, it has really brought a catastrophic change to everyone. So that is also, like, say, how we live, how we work, how we manage our life, everything, our socialism, everything is being changed. Now, if you look at it, India, say there are a lot of shortcomings of the healthcare system people have seen. And then people have seen, like, say, how we are struggling in the economy as well. So I'll not go very political in this. But what I feel is, like, what we can learn from here is, normally, this is what my experience and what I understand, that we Indians are very good. We're very good in delivering when the crisis happens. We are at the best. If you look at the cricket game also, I've seen very few games where those have been won with the plan. So all respect to our players, there is nothing. but you have seen a lot of cricket matches where, I'm just setting one example.
The backs are against the ball. The last is, example, prime example, is the Australian series.
Yes.
Yes.
Yeah.
And if I remember the great 1983 World Cup, the match, I think no one, that match was not telecasted. The Kapil Dev has hit 175. And they went on winning the World Cup itself when they were underdog. Yeah. So this is what a firm belief I have, like, so people are normally deliver best in the crisis, but that is not going to work anymore. As in management, like, say, it's all basics what people are teaching in the management or people follow in the management. And I think most of the business houses are following that. However, that has to be in the individuals, governments, and everyone, where you need to have a long-term visions, plan, and execution of a plan. And the most important, what I feel, is a risk assessment, which we don't do.
Hmm.
So there has to be, having said that, is a risk assessment. Now, working in a pharmaceutical, we do understand, because it's a mandate for us to do a risk assessment for every system that we implement in the industry company. However, the risk assessment we do is out of not with the exact risk what we could. Now, having said that, it is not necessary that you have done all the planning, risk. These uncertainties will not be faced. These will be faced. However, you need to be ready for that. Now, when this volatility happens, the ability to learn and react is very important, which we need to learn.
Sure.
But you need to be very quick. You need to have an advanced resources and everything, a bank available with you, you can research, bank upon, right? So then when uncertainty is there, then you need to analyze your available information. You need to collaborate with the experts. So this is how you can come over the uncertainty, because having said that, whatever risk assessment of these uncertainties are going to be faced, not very often, but this one. And to meet up your complexity, you need to have a right set of experts with you who can manage your complexities.
Yes.
And ambiguity, adaptability, and flexibility is a key for anyone, whether it is an organization, government, or a people. So you need to be adaptable to these situations. So, and you need to be very flexible to the situation, because what we have understood, we learned, and is the tagline of company, the change in the constant, the change is a constant. So you need to work, and you need to be flexible with the situation and the adaptability. And that is why I said I never stick to a particular type of a leadership. You need to be very flexible, use whatever style comes and situation and environment comes in. That's all. So this is what I feel like when this in this view, so this is what a great learning, and we should
sure.
see how we plan and do a risk assessment prominently, so to avoid such situations, or even we face this situation, how we can come over these situations.
Sure. I am totally on board with all the thoughts that you've tabled. Thank you for sharing your insights.
Thank
you. Okay, Ashok, with that, what we'll do is we'll move on to another section, which is called the one word, one line answer. I'm going to throw some questions of you, and please respond to these questions either in a word or in an answer. So it's a light section. So are you ready for this?
I hope I pass out all your questions.
I'll tell you, you'll pass 100 on 100, because there are no wrong answers. there are only right answers. Okay, there are no wrong answers. So you will get 100 on 100 on this in this section.
It's a long time I have not appeared for exams. Thanks, okay. Thanks for that experience again.
Okay. This is more like prelims. This is more like, yeah, an oral test or a viva. Yeah. So take it as that.
Yeah.
What's, let's go for it. Ashok, what's your favorite meal or dish?
Rice and sambar.
Okay. Favorite holiday destination?
Kashmir.
Most hated subject in school?
Maths.
Really? Okay. Favorite subject?
Favorite subject, yeah.
That's your favorite subject? Maths is your favorite subject?
Yeah, yeah.
Okay, then I'm going to ask you, what's your most hated subject in school?
Biology.
Ah, okay. If your name, I mean, your name is there, Ashok, what would its tagline be? If your name were a logo, what would its tagline be?
Jo kabhi shok nahi karta. It's a meaning of my...
Wow, wonderful. Wonderful. What is the one thing most people don't know about you?
It's about my mood.
Is your mood? Okay. Okay. Would you prefer to have more time or more money?
More time.
City life or small town life?
Small town life. I enjoy that.
Okay. Comfortable silences or incredible conversations?
I always have followed, like, say, speech is silver and silence is a gold.
Wonderful. Excellent. Nice answer. Spirituality or religion?
Spirituality.
5-day cricket or T20 cricket?
T20.
Chocolate or pickle?
Pickle.
Okay. Would you rather be yourself and nobody likes you, or not be yourself and everybody likes you?
It's very difficult to answer, because I like both.
One, choose one.
Okay. So I like to be self, rather given a choice in these two options. So I'd like to
it's
be.
It's a matter of which, whether they like you or not. Yeah. Yeah, I get it. Would you rather live in a peaceful dictatorship or in a chaotic democracy?
I would rather leave the first option, the dictatorship.
Peaceful dictatorship. Peaceful, okay. Dictatorship. Would you rather be lost on a mountain or lost on an island?
Lost on an island.
Okay. If you were to be stuck in a room for 24 hours, who would you choose to be stuck with? I'm going to give you three options. Subhash Chandra Bose, Greta Thunberg, or A.B. de Villiers?
Subhash Chandra Bose.
Okay. Would you rather travel back in time to meet your ancestors, or would you rather go to the future to meet your descendants?
I would like to meet my ancestors.
Very sweet. If you could be a kitchen appliance, what one would you be and why?
Kitchen appliance. I'd be like say the spoon who can
Okay.
gather everything and mix up and make a blend of whatever is getting cooked.
Fantastic answer. Lovely. If you were an animal, what animal would that be?
I would be elephant.
Okay. If you had to teach a class on one thing at a moment's notice, what would you teach?
I would rather tell about the values of the life to someone. What are the values in your life?
Excellent. Excellent. I'm sure you must have read comics when you were young. So, what's your all-time favorite comic book character?
Chacha Chaudhary.
Ah, lovely. Do you believe in fate or do you think we're in complete control of our circumstances?
I believe in faith.
Okay. In this segment, last two questions. Which three people, living or dead, and these could even be fictional people, characters, something from comic books or movies or whatever it is. Which three people, living or dead, would you like to have a cutting chai conversation with?
One living Bachchan ji, Amitabh Bachchan ji.
Okay.
Definitely,
Okay.
I would like to have a conversation with him, like I'm having with you right now.
Yes.
And if given a chance, I would like to have a conversation. If I talk about the people, those who are not available with us right now, so I would definitely would like to have my conversation with Mahatma Gandhi. That is
Excellent.
one because his thoughts and
Sure,
the way
sure.
he drove the entire peaceful peacefully. So that. What attracts me, and third would be definitely Dhirubhai Ambani, who can teach us a life how
Fantastic.
to business.
What a wonderful trio you've chosen. And you would conduct the cutting chai conversation and ask them questions for 20 minutes. I can imagine how invigorating that session would be. Final question in this particular segment. Life is incomplete without, kindly fill in the blanks or complete the sentence. Life is incomplete without.
My family.
Excellent. Before I let you go, I'm going to take 30 seconds more and ask you one final question. If you were the CIO of India, what is that one thing that you would do?
Sure. It's a very favorite question you have asked me. Like I said, it's very near to me because I always keep on thinking of what I can do for a nation or whatever. So, if I'm a CIO of a appointed a CIO of a country, so there are multiple. Like say, the current prime minister has taken up digital journey, whether it is a digital economy or smart cities or something. What prominently I would like to do is digitalize the healthcare now. I'm not saying that there is no initiative or there are no apps available as of now, but however, I would like to see how the healthcare is being digitalized now, which will bring a transparency in the system, and it will also help everyone by connecting the dots. Now, I'll give you a simple example. Like say one when person goes and meet the medical practitioners. So we don't have any records of what has been diagnosed, what has been treated. Now that is a painful. Like I don't know how many of us even we come from an educated background. But if you ask me what has happened 10 years back, if any surgery, what treatment, which doctor, I don't know. Unless and until I have maintained those records, and I'm sure very few people are maintaining those records. Now. This will be very good for patient by themselves. Like say, if I had to move from one place to another place by some reasons, business traveling or whatever, so I don't have records what my earlier doctors has treated me. So I can get back. Government can get a lot of benefits by connecting dots. Like say, what is the healthcare system? What are the diseases? Those are coming prominent. Which section? What is the demographic of the ill people or whatever? So and then. Medical practitioners themselves would get a lot of benefits of this. So here I'm talking about connecting the dots because there is a simple information which can leverage to a lot of people. So
absolutely,
medical practice, they don't know what, so they ask patient to go for do your testings again and again, because they don't have your past histories or what. So your treatment is being delayed in that. So how you can do, and finally to the healthcare companies, those who are providing services. So today they are collecting a lot of data from the market, but this particular digitalization can help them to understand which product moving, what product they need to concentrate. So in all, I would like to digitalize the healthcare system of India, where it will bring a transparency to the everyone, and it will benefit to everyone by connecting dots of the data. So definitely, I would like to work.
Excellent. Excellent. Friends, that was Ashok Naik, Chief Information Officer, IPCA Laboratories Limited. I had a fantastic time because Ashok tabled and shared his insights, his thoughts. He was very open, very frank, and I thoroughly enjoyed this candid conversation with Ashok. I hope you did too.
Thanks, Yvonne. And thank you. It was my pleasure to talking to you, and thanks for this.